Heavenly Father, we are gathered here in the name of Jesus to worship you, Lord. Father, help us to prepare our hearts to come to the throne, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Thank you, Jesus. We love you, Lord.
Thank you.
You're the reason that I live, the reason that I sing with all I am.
Thank you, Lord. That was so good. I'm gonna do it again.
Jesus.
Come together because of you, Lord. In Jesus' name, thank you, Lord.
Amen.
And we thank you, Brother Young, for his request for this song that he felt touched his heart in such a powerful way.
So much, Brother Thomas and Brother Yong. You see the two brothers. Hallelujah. We give a big hand. We thank God for that. And the opportunity that the family will worship together, and that is a very, very beautiful thing. We thank you for the song. That is also one of my favorite songs also. So we love it. So we all believe that God is going to do miracles and God is going to bring us through. Amen. Let us open together in Psalm 69 today. And let me give you a warning about this psalm. How many of you are very disappointed? How many of you are feeling very sad? How many of you don't want to smile? How many of you feel that tomorrow is very uncertain or the future is uncertain? So when you read this psalm at the beginning, you will feel you will go down further. you will feel that you're going to the pit, and it's not going to encourage us at all. But don't be disappointed. God is always faithful, and He is going at the end. He's going to encourage us. Amen. Okay. So if you have that, you can also read together. It's a very long psalm. And I think the reason why it's very long because it also depicts or express our emotion. You see, when we are happy, happy, and that's it. But when we are so down, when it's painful, when we have the agony, then it seems to be prolonged from one century to another century. So you put that emotion and read this psalm together and understand what does that mean. But at the same time, also thank God that we are the people who are called by God. And even though there's some humiliation, even though there's some obstacle, but we thank God and trust God that we can still move on. Okay, let us read together and what does it mean? And then I'm going to paraphrase that very quickly after that. Let us begin together in verse number one. Save me, O God, for the waters have come up to my neck. You see? Did I promise you that it will make you to feel even more sadder, even you feel that more disappointed? Okay, verse number two, let's begin. I sing in the miry depths where there is no foothold. I have come into the deep waters. The floods engulf me. I'm worn out calling for help. My throat is parched. My eyes fail looking for my God. Those who hate me without reason outnumber the hairs of my head. Many are my enemies without cause, those who seek to destroy me, and forces to restore what I did not steal. Can you see, if you are so sad and you read this one, maybe you know we don't want to move it on, right? Okay. But that's not enough. You got to know my folly. My guilt is not hidden from you. Lord, the Lord Almighty, may those who hope in you not be disgraced because of me. God of Israel, may those who seek you not be put to shame because of me. Let's read together from verse 7. For I endure scorn for your sake, and shame covers my face. I'm a foreigner to my own family, a stranger to my own mother's children. For zeal for your house consumes me, and the insult of those who insult you fall on me. When I weep and fast, I must endure scorch. When I put on sackcloth, people make sport of me. Those who sit at the gates mock at me, and I am the song of the drunkards. But I pray to you, Lord, in the time of your favor, in your great love, O God, answer me with your sure salvation. Rescue me from the mire. Do not let me sink. Deliver me from those who hate me, from the deep waters. Do not let the flood waters engulf me, or the depth swallow me up, or the pit close its mouth over me. Is that enough? Maybe some of you said, that's enough for me. Okay, but it's not that enough. You still have another half of this. What else? Let's begin. Answer me, Lord, out of the goodness of your love. In your great mercy, turn to me. Do not hide your face from your servant. Answer me quickly, for I am in trouble. Come near and rescue me. Deliver me because of my fault. You know how I am scorned, disgraced, and shamed. All my enemies are before you. Scorn have broken my heart and has left me helpless. I looked for sympathy, but there was none. For comforters, but I found none. They put gall in my food and gave me vinegar for my thirst. You see, from description, from the physical, from the emotion, from the food, from everything, from the friendship, everything is seen, it doesn't go well. And this go very well with my message today. How we've been in tough situation, okay? Okay, let us move on and find the encouragement as we are moving out. May the table set before them become a snare. May it become a retribution and a trap. May their eyes be darkened so they cannot see, and their backs be bent forever. Pour out your wrath on them. Let your fierce anger overtake them. May their place be deserted. Let there be no one to dwell in their tent. For they persecute those you wound, and talk about the pain of those who hurt. Charge them with crime upon crime. Do not let them share in your salvation. May they be blotted out of the book of life, and not be listed with the righteousness. You see that when we're so disappointed, you even curse some other people. You see, so get their name out of the book of life. Even though we don't have the decision to make for that one. God is the one who wrote that name. You see, but sometimes when life is come over us, when we are being engulfed with the water, and then it's not enough. He said, but as for me, afflicted and in pain, may your salvation, God protect me. So I'm asking, how many of you are in this situation? But today we can do opposite. We can do in another way that we can see that change is going to happen in our own life. That we are going to see that the miracles of God. And here we see the psalmist begin to say, welcome, Sister Ruth. Welcome, Sister Ruth. And then God said, and the psalmist said, I will praise God's name in song. Amen. We will sing in song. God, and glorify him with thanksgiving. This will please the Lord more than an ox, more than a bull with his horn and hooves. The fool will see and be glad. Those who seek God and may your heart light. The Lord hears the needy and does not despise his captive people. Let heaven and earth praise him, the sea and all that move in him. For God will save Zion and rebuild the cities of Judah. The people will settle there and possess it. The children of his servant will inherit it, and those who love his name will dwell there. Welcome, Sister Ruth and our sister. Wonderful. And we would love to hear your testimony later on. Okay. Now, Psalm 69, it seems to be a very painful psalm for every one of us. But we can do it otherwise. Okay? So in every sentence, when I finish, you just said, praise the Lord. You see? In all of the situation, Hard time, praise the Lord. Bad time, praise the Lord. Sickness, praise the Lord. No money, praise the Lord. You know, you can change the situation around. Okay? You can change the situation around. The devil say this, but I'm saying I will praise the Lord.
Amen.
Is that okay?
Yes.
Are you ready to do that?
Yes.
Father, save me, for the water have come up to my neck.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. So when I sing in the mirror death,
praise the
Lord. Where there is no foot home.
Praise the Lord.
When I have come into the deep waters.
Praise the Lord.
When the flood engulfed me.
Praise the Lord.
Are you serious?
Yes.
But you know that this is how the principle that we can become an overcomer. Because when we begin to just let the water just overcome us, then we are done. We finish. Okay? But when we begin to say, praise the Lord, when I'm worn out calling for help, praise the Lord. When my throat is parched, praise the Lord. When my eyes fail, praise the Lord. Though when I hate me without any reason, you remember, praise the Lord. When we're being hate without any reason, do you have anything like that? I have more than enough. And then, it said that when my enemies seek me to destroy me without any causes.
Praise the Lord.
I'm forced to restore what I did when I forced to restore what I did not steal.
Praise the Lord.
Are you serious?
Yes. Praise the Lord.
People say that you have to pay something that we didn't take away. Injustice, in other words. My guilt is not hidden from you. And he said that disgrace will come before me.
Praise the Lord.
Shame come before me.
Praise the Lord.
Are you serious?
Yes.
So this is only the principle that you and I, you see that, you can see from my life. This is one of the things that I can share boldly about this one. I will not let the water engulf me, because I will say, out of that situation, I will say, praise the Lord. Later I will give you the testimony and you will understand. And then when the enemies come and begin to accuse me, I just praise the Lord. I don't look into that situation, because I know that when I look into that situation, the situation will kill me. The situation will destroy me. The situation will steal my potential. The situation will continue to block me from moving forward. And that's why when one place closed, we have a better place. We have a bigger place. We have a more beautiful place. You see, we have a bigger place, a better place, a more beautiful place. We play word here. Hallelujah. You see, only in the situation like this, then the poetic will come up. If not, it doesn't come up. So if you're going through this one, I will talk about that later. So would you really just stand up for a moment and just open in Psalm chapter 69 and begin to pray. Is there anything, any areas in our life that we cannot praise the Lord? Is there any burdens that were so heavy that we cannot praise the Lord? Is there any poverty that we are facing that we cannot say, praise the Lord? Is there any broken relationship that we cannot say, I cannot praise the Lord? Today, let us begin to say it back, okay? Because at the end, it's long one, so I'm not going to repeat it again. But at the end, we see that God is the one who gave us life.
Yes.
Amen.
So what does it mean? He gave us the life of abundance. So when we say a life of abundance here, poverty is nothing. When we talk about a life of abundance here, we talk about accusation is nothing. Oppression is nothing. Lack is nothing. Sickness is nothing. Because you and I can claim an abundant life in the name of Jesus. Because God will continue to give you and I a new song, and we begin to glorify Him with thanksgiving. Amen?
Amen.
I didn't hear your amen.
Amen.
What I hear? Amen.
Amen.
Okay, just come and begin to pray together right now. And just ask God to give us a new song that God is going to open our heart.
Thank you.
We are going to enter into the time of praise and worship. That we just said, Father, in the midst of the situation, I'm going to praise Him.
whatever the things that is going through in my life, I'm going to praise Him. I want to develop a better relationship. I want to seek Your face. And I want to see that my hand, my head will be lifted up. I want to see that God, You're going to bring me through in a tough situation, a good situation, in a bad situation, and a better situation. And I will continue to follow You. And I will continue to be faithful to You. Would you please just lift up your voice and begin to pray right now? And just call upon the name of the Lord right now. And maybe some of you need to look back into Psalm chapter 69. Just go ahead and do so. And begin to use those psalms and those scriptures and begin to pray to the Lord right now.
Thank you. Good as bread, how you match Jesus.
We pray for the revival. Right now, just ask Lord.
Receive your word in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for every heart that hear, oh Lord. We dedicate our Holy Spirit right now and bless our hearts with the word of God as we worship you in spirit and in truth. Be glorified in this house and in this temple and in our hearts, and bless our children and bless our family and continue to bless this church in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for your word, which is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, which has delivered us from all evil. Be glorified right now as we listen to the word of God. Have your way in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, everybody say amen.
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 Hallelujah. Thank you so much, Pastor. Okay, let us have a time to give the testimony this afternoon. And Sister Ruth also invite one of our sisters, and she also have a very good testimony. Would you please just come and share your testimony so that everyone will be encouraged? Okay, Sister Ruth and our sister. Mm-hmm. And give them a big hand and welcome them in this house. Amen. Of God.
Praise the Lord, you know, and Pastor Joe, it was the same with my sister Carmen. We came a couple weeks ago. Carmen came with me and met Pastor Joshua and saw the shows. And we were at our home church, Victory Outreach, this morning. And then but Carmen kept being led. She's like, we need to go to Pastor Joshua's worship, because she's a worshiper. Uh-huh. And so I'm just blessed. We're blessed to be here with the family of God. And I'm just so grateful to the Lord Jesus. because I didn't know I was going to be testifying, but I do have a praise report, and because I was has the job for me.
Amen.
But right now I'm not employed, but I'm employed by the Lord because I'm in ministry helping Pastor Joshua's church and our church, and I'm busy all the time.
Yes.
And so I had just paid my rent and my bank account. If I looked at it, of course, then you know the enemy's trying to attack me, but I kept speaking out when the enemy would try to tell me, oh, what are you going to do? What's, you know, you better do this, better do that. No, the Lord's telling me what to do. And I kept speaking that Proverbs 8:21, where it says, the Lord is saying, I bestow wealth upon those who love me.
Yes.
Making their treasury full. Every time the enemy would do that, and literally one time I was being attacked, and the Lord said, no, you're going to go, I needed something. Why? Because I don't have that much money. The Holy Spirit said, no, you need to go. And as I'm in the store buying what the Lord told me I needed to buy, somebody sent me, it was Prophetess Cora, she put money in my bank account. The same, and I was speaking that scripture out, and the money came in right when I'm walking out of the store with the purchase the Lord told me to make. And then, this right after I paid my rent, and that, my taxes came back, I got back more money in 1 week than my tax, than my rent was. So I just have to encourage you to speak out God's word. And just like Pastor Joshua was saying, praise God no matter what. Praise Him, speak out His word. Don't look at the circumstances because they will harm us. Just like He was saying, if we look only at the circumstances and we're not looking at God, we don't tell people about the circumstances being bad. We tell the circumstances about our God who is bigger than the circumstances. Amen.
Amen.
God
bless you. Hallelujah. What a powerful testimony. Praise the Lord.
Hi, I'm Sister Carmen, and as Sister Ruthie was saying, we do attend Victory Outreach, but it's a tremendous blessing to be here. Last week, I got a chance to watch Pastor Joshua on a video on YouTube, and I was blessed, you know, and I mentioned to Ruthie, we need to go over there to the studio on a Sunday afternoon.
Yeah.
That was worship. Beautiful worship. But I've been saved over, I would say, 35 years. I was a drug addict, lost and bound in the city of Santa Ana. And God pulled me out of that pit and has done a tremendous work in my life. He's led me of ministry. I've done prison ministry, worship in church, and prayer, intercessory prayer. So God has me just abundantly blessed.
Amen, amen.
And I'm now blessed, even though you see I have injuries, but I'm still going. I'm still going forward for the Lord, and nothing's going to hold me back.
Amen.
Just recently, you know, I had a death in my family, which that was really, really difficult. My mom, I'm now orphaned because I've lost my dad also, and my younger brother. I feel like I'm going to cry right now. But just very, very close to all three of them. And I know they're in heaven because they were all saved, and they were in church with me also. And I love them. I love them, and I know I'm going to see them again. Started and orphan, whatever they say that you are, you know, when you're. But I still have Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus.
Yes.
And He just continually blesses me with intercessors like Ruthie and other people at church that. You know, and I know I have people that I don't even know that are praying for me. And it's only by the grace of God that I'm standing here and I didn't run back to drugs, back to drinking, doing the stay. God kept me. He didn't let me go. He didn't let me wander off. And so that's why I'm here. Still saved. Saved by the grace of God. God bless you.
Wow. What a great testimony. We thank you so much. And I believe that the message today, God wanted me to preach this one, is for you. Of course, for all of us,
And for those of us who do not know Sister Ruth yet, she's a prayer warrior of Vision TV in our church. Today, officially, we introduce the prayer warriors who have been praying for us. And we thank God for all the opportunity that they can come. They come almost every day, and we have Sister Wanda and Pastor Vivian who also come to pray. So it's time that God said that we need to go to a bigger place. Because we are going to have a lot of prayer warriors to come. And they contact many prayer warriors, but you see that because of the elevator. So we need to have on the first floor, and you're going to see that every night we have a lot of prayer warriors are praying together with us. Amen. Okay, thank you so much for coming, and thank you for sharing.
Thank you.
And just welcome anytime and serve together as you pray and worship together. Now, how many of you remember the topic that I was sharing with you last week? If you missed that message, look and begin to watch it, or if you lost about point one of your life. Okay, just a little bit. Okay, that message is going to encourage you and going to challenge you a lot. How many of you still remember the message that I was sharing about last week about the story of Deborah? And many times that the people were preaching about Deborah, about her courage. But last time I was preaching about arise and shine. Okay, there's two words that God has mentioned in the book of Judges chapter 6. Is that awake and arise. And I was sharing with you about that. But today, we are going to learn with a new person. One who is very familiar to many of us. You still remember? What is his name? In Judges chapter 6. Okay, yes, you are right. That is about Gideon. So, we were talking
about Gideon.
Okay, would you please just open, and if you miss about the story of Deborah, let me go a little bit, and then I'm going to go into the scripture for today in the book of Judges chapter 6 today. So last time we talked about Deborah, she was a very remarkable person. She's a judge, she's a military strategist, a poet, and a prophet, you see? So here, for many of us who are women and ladies and many church tradition or even the legend or even the tradition of our society or our culture sometimes just put us down and do not promote the ministry of the ladies. So let us be encouraged through the life of the prophetess Deborah. So from the story of Deborah, we talk about awake, being awakened. And I was talking to you about awakening our potential, awakening our conscience. Maybe for so long, because of the situation, sometime all of these things already lost. Whether it is the dream or the courage or the initiative. Whether it is the gift or the potential or the power that God has given to every one of us. So let us pray that God will awaken those potential, the power, the gift, the and we were also talking about awakening from the deception of the devil, from the control of the tradition. We are talking about destructive word of the enemies. And then I was sharing with you that from a different angle from our church. Our church need to arise. Arise from the division. Arise from the lack of the dreams. Arise from the poverty mindset. And we also share about from our personal family as well. That we also need to arise from all the problem and headache of the family that we have. But when we talk about arise and arise, but today we move to another topic that it seems to go in contrast with what we call arise. And what is this about? Okay, My topic for you today is that are we in tough situation? And most of the time that all of us will say yes. Whether we like it or not, from time to time, we have to go through the tough situation. And I try to preach two sermons on one chapter, right? So at least for the book of Gideon, for about the life of Gideon, we have 6 sermons. And the first thing is that, are we in the tough situation? And what do I mean by that? Chapter 6, from verse 1 said, the Israelite did evil in the eyes of the Lord, and for 7 years he gave them into the hands of the Midianites. So the Bible said that the Israelite was in captivity for 7 years, not only by the Midianites. And the Bible said in verse number 2, because the power of the Midian was so oppressive. They are not only so strong, they are not only so powerful, but they said that they are so oppressive. And the Israelite prepared shelter for themselves in the mountain cleft. And as you can see that they cannot live in a very natural home that they have. They cannot live in their villages. But the Bible said they have to live in the mountain cleft. They have to go up to the mountain. They have to live in the cave. What was the reason? In order to get away from the killing or the oppression of the enemies. And the Bible said that whenever the Israelites planted the crops, the enemies tried to destroy everything. So the Midianites, the Amalekites, and then all the eastern people who invade the country. So the situation is that not only one enemy, but there are so many enemies who are surrounding them. And the enemy came on the land and ruined the crops all the way to Gaza. And the good thing is that the enemies that did not spare anything. And you can see that from this situation, the situation was not very easy for the Israelites. Because the enemy did not spare a living thing for Israel, neither sheep nor cattle nor donkeys. In other words, they have no food to eat. They were going through a famine. They were going through a hard time. And then they came up with their livestock and their tent like swarm of locusts. Now, this is a very good metaphor, like swarm of locusts. How many of you have seen the swarm of the locusts moving? How many of us want to go against them? I don't think so. So the enemies were so many. They are innumerable. These are the correct words.
Okay.
And it was impossible to count them. Or even their camels. And the good news is, the enemies invade and ravage the land. So, did you see some of the word that the Bible used here? The enemy was very oppressive. The enemy was invading the land. The enemy did not spare anything left. And what? To ravage everything. So if we put ourselves in that shoe, we will know how painful it was for the Israelites. Not only that, verse number 6 said, the Midianites so impoverished the Israelites. And at this moment, the Israelites cannot bear it, so they have to call out upon the name of the Lord. So what are we going to do today? So my question for you is that, have we ever been in this crisis? God did not go through just like the Israelites. Maybe some of us do not have the oppression that's so hard. Maybe our situation is not that harsh. Maybe our boss or some of the competitors still leave some way for every one of us. But just like our sister Ruth and our sister just share one ago. Maybe sometimes our job was not stable. Or even worse, no job at all. Just like me. But the good news, I have the call. Hallelujah. I have no job, but I have the call. I will tell you about more about. And maybe some of you have many payments must be made. And you look at the bill, look at the bill. Water bill, trash bill, insurance bill, car bill, whatever you name it. And you will begin to see those crises that we have. And yet, no money left. And maybe no friends left. Or even someone just walk away from our life. And recently you hear so many stories that when the husband lost a job, they lost everything, and the wife also said, goodbye, my love. When you lose job, lose money, you lose your business, you lose your project, you also lose your loved one, maybe some of us. And then suddenly you find that you have new sicknesses. And then everything that you try is a failure. In other words, you fail in every attempt that you make. And especially as a man, how do you feel that? As a head of the family, you cannot provide anything for the family. Yes, I've been going through many times this situation. No job, only the call. And that's worse. I was sharing with you many times before that even our son had to drink the cheapest meal ever. And if you heard about the scandal in China in 2009, about the three deer milk powder, the milk powder that had the scandal and had the melan, what is that? That kind of chemical. It's very harmful to the children. And it destroyed the many kidneys of the children. And it even caused death among the children. So, maybe some of us are going through. Whether the relationship issue, or maybe it's a financial issue, maybe the job issue, or maybe the in-laws issue. Or maybe the corruption issue. Now, look at Gideon, the first thing that he was facing. Is that about the job problem? His name means cutter or cutter of trees. So this name will tell us he's a woodman. He does something. He's a carpenter maybe. Or he could also be a farmer. But as you can see, the situation at that time, he had no job at all. In that situation, who will buy the chair or the table that he made? And even when he was a farmer, the enemies already destroyed everything. They ravaged everything. You don't see any hope. You don't see any perspective of a future. And not only that, he had to live in a mountain without a job. The crop was already destroyed by the enemies. Maybe he had to do other job, had to find other job. Instead of doing the job that he knew. Now, the job has always been an issue for many of us. For some of us, it may not be the problem that we have no job, but the problem that we have to move to a new place. It is only in 1 or 2 hours.
Ở California chúng ta có thể lái xe 1 hay 2.
But then they move us to Dakota.
Đi về Dakota.
North.
Ở phía vùng Bắc đó.
Where we don't like the cold.
Chúng ta không chịu được.
Where we don't like the snow.
Tuyết rơi.
And it gives us a lot of fears.
Và đưa đến chúng ta nhiều sự sợ.
It gives us also a lot of uncertainty.
Điều tương lai bất.
Even though I was preaching to you powerfully.
Nghe là tôi dạy chúng mình.
But at night when I begin to think about tomorrow.
Nhưng mà mỗi đêm khi tôi nghĩ về tương lai ngày mai.
I also don't know what to do.
Tôi cũng không biết phải làm cái gì.
It's just like many of you.
Cũng như là
and many of us here. Job is one of the main concerns that all of us have.
Công việc làm là cái mối quan ngại.
When we have a good job, when we have a stable job, it's fine.
Khi chúng ta có công việc làm vững chắc thì đó là tốt.
But I thank God, last time I heard from Pastor Sherida.
Trước tôi nghe và
and I think this is very a good encouragement for us.
Đây là cái câu mà rất là.
She said when she have a good job.
Thì tôi có bạn nói khi tôi.
She could not afford to buy a house.
Tôi không có đủ tiền để mua nhà.
God is the one who provides a house for us. Isn't it amazing? But sometimes all of the natural situation will cause us some of the fear and uncertainty. Or at least it will cause us some of the sleeplessness.
Gây chúng ta những đêm không ngủ, mất ngủ.
Or maybe sometimes it will also cause us some of the questions to God.
Và những lúc chúng ta phải đặt câu hỏi với Chúa.
It's just like Gideon. Upset.
You
know that at that time, because no money,
thì lúc đó không có tiền.
And in my situation, I have the same situation at that time.
Ngay cả tôi cũng bị.
Many times when I walk out, I just slam the door.
Và nhiều lúc tôi ra bên ngoài tôi liền cho con đá con chó.
And at home, I don't want to shout, but I go out. Because I don't want my wife to hear that cry of mine.
Mà tôi không muốn vợ tôi nhà vợ tôi có nghe những
cái la. Out of desperation, I begin to shout in order to let me feel a little bit better.
Khi mà tôi la như vậy thì cảm thấy sự thoải mái.
So if sometime if you walk around suddenly saw Pastor Paul is there.
Khi mà tôi cảm thấy mình thấy mà tôi.
My pressure.
Đó là cách mà tôi đã giải tỏa được cái sự vậy.
It's a how that I can feel. It's a lot better when I begin to shout.
Khi mà tôi làm như vậy thì như nó sẽ.
And I don't know how about Gideon or how about you.
Tôi không biết là Gideon như quý vị như thế nào.
Some people will go for.
Đến để uống một cốc.
And then you get an accident. That was.
Khi mà
so don't do so. At least you can slam the door.
Mà quý vị có thể đập cửa nhưng mà.
But don't hit your TV. But you see that here in the situation of Job is situation where we do not have.
Nói tới vấn đề công việc là chúng ta không có cái sự bình an thế nào.
How can we have peace when I always have to think about where's the money to buy milk for my son?
Và sự bình an thế nào khi mà tôi nghĩ đến
at that time that we don't have money even money in order to buy the diaper.
Và ngay lúc đó thì chúng tôi không có tiền để mua những cái tã cho con.
And we have to use the old clothes and cut it.
Và tôi phải dùng cái quần áo cũ để mà cắt ra.
But that is the best.
Nhưng mà đó là cái cách tốt nhất.
Because that's natural.
Đó là tự nhiên.
What you are using for your children is unnatural.
Điều gì quý vị dùng cho con cái hiện giờ là không có tự nhiên.
So it's not very good. So we use the natural one. So it's very good.
Tôi dùng cái thiên nhiên.
And that is how I can comfort myself.
Đó là điều mà tôi yêu mình tốt.
And I was sharing with you that I was every time that look poo poo and then immediately this is a day.
Và khi mà nó ỉ ra, lúc đó ỉ ra thì tôi phải.
Unlike the diaper, we just threw away, but here the natural one we wash.
Lúc đó nhưng mà dùng bã thì tôi phải rửa.
And when he pee pee and then we say celebrate, Jesus celebrate. Is it easy for us when we lose a job or when we have no job, when we have no family, no money?
Chúng ta mất việc làm không có tiền.
And that's what Gideon was facing.
Đó là cái điều mà cái hoàn cảnh mà
Gideon đang đối diện. Not only about the job, but it's also his family.
Không phải là công việc làm không phải cái gia đình của ông nữa.
And the Bible will tell us at least something here.
Mà
the angel of the Lord came and sat down under the oak in Ophrah.
Và thiên sứ đến cái chỗ mà cái cây thụ.
That belonged to the Joash the Abiezerite.
Và đến một cái nơi mà của các người
Abiezerite. In the history that we can see that this family is not famous at all.
Và tôi biết là cái gia đình này không có.
They're just ordinary people.
phản ứng người bình thường thôi.
And you see that especially with a common and a not very a very ordinary people in the situation like this is worse.
Và trong một cảnh những người mà bình thường như vậy, trong một cảnh như thế thì rất là.
If the rich at least we can still have some saving.
Số người chúng ta còn số tiền để.
At least we can still have some relationship
to ask for. Và có liên hệ khác.
At least we still have we hide go somewhere and begin to go and do and get the food.
Chúng ta có thể là giấu vàng rồi đó, có thể đem lên đi bán.
But for Gideon, it seemed that they almost had nothing left.
Rồi đối với Gideon thì hoàn toàn không còn.
And the Bible said he had to thresh the wheat in a wine press to keep it from the Midianite.
Rồi ông phải làm mọi thứ để mà chống trả đến Midianite.
And because the Midian was so oppressive, they had to live in the cave in the mountain, and we just share what God.
Và như là để sống trong một cái hầm mộ trong một cái.
So what is the situation of our family today?
Đối với gia đình chúng ta giờ thì.
And of course, I have a lot of thought about my family.
Dĩ nhiên tôi phải nghĩ đến.
Because we always have a lot of things. We have gone through trouble. We gone through issues.
Tôi có nhiều sự khó khăn đủ thứ cả.
We gone through the persecution from the government.
Tôi đã bị sự bắt bớ chính phủ.
We gone through the accusation of even the believers.
Ngay cả những người cũng đã bị bắt bớ rồi.
We also gone
tin Chúa nữa.
Gone through many threat, many risk in mission.
Qua ngay cả những lúc mà nguy hiểm.
And we also gone through the separation.
Và ngay những lúc mà chuẩn bị.
We also gone through the good time and the bad time.
Chúng ta qua những lúc mà lên, chúng ta cũng đã xuống.
But how about no food for the family?
Không có tiền, không có thức ăn cho gia đình.
I'm not sure if you've gone through that.
Tôi không biết là quý vị có trải qua
in America.
Ở Hoa Kỳ này nhỉ?
But last time I heard some of the story, especially Vietnamese boat people.
Và đối với người mà thường dân.
They are hungered to death.
Và họ đã đói gần chết.
And how is it when you witness your son and your daughter have no food to eat and they die in front of you?
Tôi vì sẽ làm gì khi mà cái con cái của mình nó không có con?
Also go through that.
Tôi cũng đi qua những cái thảm cảnh.
Because of the persecution, so my father-in-law was put in prison.
Thì sự bắt bớ trong gia đình chúng tôi, gia đình bố vợ của tôi cũng bị bắt bớ.
And then the neighbors cannot come close to.
Những người làm lại, những người xung quanh đấy không có dám đến gần.
Because if they come, they will be persecuted as well.
Những người làm xung quanh đến gần như vậy đó thì họ.
So it was so the children were so hungry that my mother-in-law had to go out and get the snow and let the children eat.
Chính vì cái sự đói khát như vậy mà mẹ vợ của tôi đi ra ngoài lấy những cái tuyết để cho con gái ăn.
Can it satisfy the hunger of the children?
Cái điều đó có thể làm thỏa mãn sự đói khát của con gái.
Maybe it is a miracle.
Nhưng mà đó chỉ là.
But you see that today that many families and many homeless people no food for them.
Nhưng mà hiện giờ đang là trong cái cảnh không có nhà cửa, không
the
có.
The living condition was terrible. The living condition was terrible.
Và cái đời sống rất là khó khăn.
And they don't have the proper schooling for the people in those days.
Và lúc đó họ không có những cái trường học mà cho con.
And when the situation like that, we see the dignity, the morals are very vulnerable.
Và lúc đó thì cái đời sống về đạo đức thì rất là.
We can begin to even to sell our soul for just a living or
và
just.
Và cái gì mà bán chúng ta không bình bán đi thân xác của mình.
For just some of the material things.
Để có một cái vật.
So I don't know what are the things that you and for those who are watching online worship together with us
online.
Maybe you and I have been going through a very, very tough time.
Và có thể quý vị là tôi trải qua cái thời kỳ khác rồi.
We have no job and our family in a very tough situation.
Chúng ta không có tiền và sống với gia đình chúng ta.
But not only that, this the third thing that we can see here, the Israelite was in a very difficult situation.
Chúng ta thấy lúc này là hoàn cảnh là người dân được thấy họ rất là khó khăn.
We talk about three things today: our job, our family, and thirdly, our security.
Nói ba thứ, thứ nhất là công việc làm của tôi, gia đình của chúng ta và cái sự an toàn.
So when we talk about this one, we know that it seems that our foundation has been shaken.
Và khi mình nói những điều này thì nói về cái nền tảng chúng ta bắt đầu đã.
For the Israelite in those days during the time of Gideon.
Và trong thời gian của dân Do Thái từ quân Gideon.
They cannot find security.
Họ cũng thấy có sự an toàn.
Death can come anytime.
Và cái sự chết chóc đang đến họ.
They have the enemies.
Và có những
the Midianite, the Amalekite, the Eastern foreigners. And I would just express a while ago, they were very oppressive.
Và họ là những người áp bức
cực kỳ. The enemy was strong and ruthless.
Họ những người rất là công bằng.
The enemy ruled their crops and their lives.
Và những người kẻ thù đó đầu.
They destroy everything.
Tại vì ngoài tất cả mọi thứ.
They spare nothing.
Họ không để làm cái gì.
They invade the lands.
Họ đã xâm nhập vào.
They ravage the land.
Họ phá hủy đất đai.
They were innumerable.
Họ số vô số.
How about in our situation today?
Đối với hoàn cảnh chúng ta ngày
nay. Maybe what are the things that cause us insecurity?
Điều gì làm chúng ta thấy cảm thấy bất an?
We don't want to go out.
Chúng ta không muốn đi ra ngoài.
We don't want to go deal with other people because we are afraid that we are going to be deceived.
Vậy chúng ta không muốn để người ta mà chúng ta.
And the Israelite for 7 years, maybe some of us already for 10 years.
Và có người chúng ta họ trẻ là 7 năm, có người đến 10 năm.
Just like the Israelite, they can
on. Và họ có thể cái sự đấu tranh của họ vật lộn qua.
They can struggle and they can name the enemies one by one, the Midianite, the Amalekite.
Họ có thể đếm từng bước một những cái.
And maybe you and I can also name our security one by one.
Chúng ta cũng thể đếm từng cái những cái sự bất toàn của chúng ta.
Just like we said one ago, no job, the family was in trouble.
Nói về rồi thì qua công việc là chúng ta không có.
The future was uncertain.
Và cái tương lai vô định.
How can we have security in that?
Chúng ta có sự yên định trong hoàn cảnh như vậy.
Unless there would be something that keep you and give you the strength
chúng
to go on.
Chúng ta có điều gì đó để làm chúng ta nâng cao chúng ta là cái tinh
thần. Our sister just mentioned while ago, the parent is gone, the brother is gone.
Và nghĩa là bởi vì chúng ta vừa nói là gia đình bắt đi rồi.
Where we find our security.
Và ngay cả cái sự mà liên hệ chúng ta.
To other people, the bank account is there.
Nghĩ là cái
chủ của họ people, là the house that they live already pay out is the security.
Họ đã đặt vào trong đó.
Rồi Dũng chắc đủ là this house I have none.
Rồi như Dũng nói là trong sao tôi cũng không có gì gì cả.
Job is only by grace, not grace.
Ân tử, cái sự ân sủng của Chúa là không.
The future is still beautiful. Hallelujah.
Hôm nay vẫn tươi đẹp.
And if you can say like that, there would be something.
Và khi mà nói điều đó được thì phải có.
But today I'm not going to talk about that. I'm talking only about the situation. The worst situation. The negative situation. The painful situation. The tragedy situation. The mourning situation. The crying situation. The situation that you cannot find any direction anymore. In order for us to remember something. In that situation, are we still faithful to God?
Trong hoàn cảnh như vậy, chúng ta vẫn còn trung tín với Chúa hay không? Cái tương lai thì vô định rồi.
And we can see that sin are rampant and wickednesses are surrounding us.
Và tội lỗi thì nó tràn đầy bên ngoài.
And maybe the persecution and oppression are so high.
Cái sự bắt bớ và cái sự là áp lực nó thì nó đè nặng trên chúng ta.
And at that time, is there any hope?
Trong hoàn cảnh như vậy thì có.
At that time they begin to call upon the name of the Lord.
Và lúc đó thì họ kêu gọi đến danh của Chúa.
The Bible says they begin to cry out to God.
Họ đã kêu cầu Chúa. Họ lúc đó.
And surprisingly, this is the answer from God.
Đây là cái sự trả lời của Chúa.
How many of you like this answer from God?
Quý vị, bao nhiêu quý vị thấy những cái câu trả lời?
At that time, God begin to send a prophet.
Và
this is what the Lord, the God of Israel, say.
Yeah, Chúa đã nói trong.
I brought you up out of Egypt. Out of the land of slavery. I rescued you from the hand of the Egyptians. And I deliver you from the hand of all of your oppression. I drove them out before you and gave you their land. I said to you, I am the Lord your God. Do not worship the God of the Amorites. But you have not listened to me. And you can see the past tense.
Cái
thing that God had doing the past.
Tất cả điều đó cho nên là trong quá khứ rồi.
If you have no job, if your family is in difficult situation, if your insecurity is high,
nếu mà trong gia đình
mà and when you call out to God and God begin to answer like this.
Và khi mà cứ gọi Chúa thì Chúa trả lời như vậy.
God, what is the use of it? Even though you need in the past, but how now and tomorrow? Maybe some of us said, Lord, this is not the answer that we need. Lord, this is not the right solution that we want to hear now. But Lord, this is out of contact. Your answer is out of contact. But the question. Are we still faithful in those moments? Even the situation are not in our favor. And even when God answers, and yet we think it's out of the context.
Mà khi chúng ta lại đó, chúng ta thấy ô không thích hợp không cả.
But actually, that is the root of our problems.
Đó chính là cái nguồn gốc.
Many times we have the problem because that was the root of our problems.
Đó là những cái nguồn gốc. Đó.
Said we have nothing because we rob God.
Đó là chúng ta không có gì cả vì chúng ta đã cướp lấy.
Many times you say we already. Because we love the world too much.
Yeah, thấy là mất đi cái niềm vui cái sự mà hăng say đối với
Chúa. Many times we say we don't know much about God because we spend too much time to pursue our education or something else.
Chúng ta thấy chúng ta không biết Chúa nhiều hơn tại theo đuổi những cái chuyện này.
Many times that we see that God, I didn't see many miracles.
Nhiều lúc chúng ta nói Chúa, chúng không còn nhìn thấy.
Just because we dare not trust in the miracles of God.
Yeah, vì chúng ta không dám tin vào cái.
Many times we say God, you are the Jehovah provider, but I didn't see that.
Và nhiều lúc chúng ta Chúa, Chúa là Jehovah cung cấp mà chúng con không
có sửa. Because we cannot hold on the promises of God.
Thì chúng ta không có nắm giữ được cái lời.
Maybe many times that we need the.
Chúng ta muốn là Chúa giải phóng chúng ta ngay lúc.
God, I need job immediately.
Chúa, con cần làm ngay bây giờ.
God, I need. I need freedom immediately.
Con muốn có sự tự do.
I need security immediately.
Con muốn sự an toàn ngay bây giờ.
I need project immediately.
Con muốn có.
I need love immediately.
Con muốn có.
I need the answer, the solution immediately.
Con muốn có cái câu trả lời, cái câu giải đáp ngay bây giờ.
But many times. In that process,
nhưng mà nhiều lúc qua những cái quá trình đó,
we forget God is teaching something very powerful and important.
Qua những quá trình đó, chúng ta nhìn rất là có ý nghĩa, rất là.
And I remember a few years ago when I had the operation of the pancreas.
Một vài năm về trước, tôi có một sự giải phẫu về tuyến tạng.
And it cost about more than $20,000.
Và đã mất phải tốn $20,000.
And you know that at that time, as we share, we offer more than 90% of our income for the ministry.
Lúc đó thì tôi đã dâng 90% của những cái
if I don't want to say even 95%. Whatever we have, we just offer for ministry.
Và những điều chúng tôi có những vụ.
And now I was in the sick bed.
Và bây giờ tôi nằm trên giường.
Andrea, just like Steve Jobs. The sickness just like Steve Jobs.
Yeah, giống như là
của
ông Steve Jobs
cũng bị như vậy. But I thank God I'm still alive today.
Cảm ơn Chúa là tôi vẫn còn sống
đến
ngày hôm nay. Hallelujah.
And then I was in the sick bed and I know the situation. I know the family have no money.
Tôi biết là khi mà dịch bệnh như vậy, tôi biết hoàn cảnh như thế nào, gia đình như thế nào lúc đó.
And yet my church member just said that you have to stay in a good place.
Và những người
out of face value, we have to stay there.
Và cái thể diện tôi phải đó.
But you know the expression, just like you sitting on fire.
Quý vị biết là mình đang ngồi trên đống lửa.
Because every day that we have to count how much money that we have to pay.
Quý vị biết là mỗi ngày tôi phải đếm là có phải trả bao nhiêu tiền không?
And that caused a lot of troubles.
Điều đó gây những sự khó khăn rất là nhiều.
But if we have not been faithful to God in a small thing.
Và nếu mà chúng ta không biết trung tín trong một việc nhỏ.
And when big things happen like this,
nhưng mà khi cái việc lớn xảy ra,
the world will be shaken.
Và cả cái bầu trời thế gian này nó sẽ rung động.
Our faith will be destroyed.
Và cái đức tin chúng ta sẽ bắt đầu sẽ bị hủy hoại.
Our hope is no more.
Chúng ta không còn cái hy vọng nữa.
We cannot trust anyone else.
Tôi không còn tin một ai cả.
And because of face value,
vì cái thể diện,
they're not open mouth and borrow the money, right?
Không thể mở miệng ra để mà mượn tiền, xin tiền.
Actually, my parents only know after when everything is fine.
Và gia đình của tôi chỉ biết khi mà mọi
chuyện xảy ra. Because we don't want to tell them about the situation so that they have no worry.
Muốn cho gia đình tôi biết từ đó để gia đình tôi lo âu cho đến khi mà chuyện đó đã xong xuôi cả.
But in that situation, what you are going to do?
Và trong giai đoạn như vậy, chúng
tôi phải làm gì? So I just lie down and just complain.
Và nó cứ phải nằm xuống là ô than phiền.
You know, at that time, just look out of the windows.
Lúc đó mình nhìn qua cửa sổ.
Look at the high rises.
Những cái tòa nhà cao trong trời.
We are right there in one of the best hospital.
Và tôi ở trong một
and we just look out and you see all the high rise and the nice, the light is on in Shanghai, beautiful.
Thì thấy những cái nhà tập trời đầy ánh sáng.
Outside is beautiful, but inside is bad.
Bên ngoài thì đẹp như thế nào thì bên trong thì quý vị biết được cảm thấy.
Outside is very luxurious, but inside we know that we are going to be bankrupt.
Tôi biết lúc nào cũng biết là đó là có sẽ đi đến sự bao.
Outside you can see the celebration of. But inside there is storm.
Và trong lòng thì này những sự sóng gió.
Is that how you feel before?
Quý vị có phải đó cái điều mà quý vị đã nghĩ trước kia như vậy phải không?
And I said, Lord, I'm ready to dedicate everything. just ask someone to write a check of $20,000 and that's
it.
Could God do so?
Yes.
I have a family who write exactly the amount in order to pay up. We said no.
Có một gia đình ở nhà thì tôi có 20,000 mà tôi nói không.
Because out of prayer, in those moments of more than 1 month, actually 2 months.
Và trong giai đoạn đó tôi cầu nguyện Chúa trong 2 tháng.
In that moment, I know that God said, "I'm your provider."
Và lúc đó thì tôi nói trong lòng tôi là Chúa là kẻ ta là người cung cấp.
And when the church member come, everyone just give exactly the same amount.
Và khi mà mỗi lúc những cô gái tôi tin, tôi chẳng nghĩ.
I don't earn more even one single cent.
Và tôi có thể
and I don't have to make up even one single cent.
Và tôi cũng không phải móc tiền túi ra một cent nào để trả trong
điều đó. Isn't God amazing?
Có thể cái điều này là
Chúa. But at that moment, I begin to teach me so many lessons.
Và những lần qua đó, tôi thấy là Chúa dạy tôi rất là nhiều.
You know, every day, because not only that, the situation was very worse.
Không phải là một cái lúc đó là tệ nhất đâu.
The doctor make a mistake.
Bác sĩ làm một sai lầm.
You know what is the mistake?
Sai lầm gì?
After the operation,
sau khi đã giải phẫu xong thành công đấy.
They put something, you know.
A sponge.
Yeah, they put a sponge inside.
Và những người khi mở xong mới không quên để một cái
They call the medical sponge.
Và cái cục
gòn. And they stick it up.
Và để quên đó rồi bắt đầu may lại. Tôi nói Chúa là sao để luôn cái da trong đó luôn.
And then they sit up and 2 days later I begin to have infection.
Và hai ngày sau đó tôi có bị
and then fever.
Và nóng sốt.
And if you see in the back of my body there's a scar over there.
Và quý vị thấy sao tôi có những
cái vết. Because now they cannot just open again.
Tôi không thể mở ra được.
You know every time just open is a very big.
Tại vì mở ra là cả vấn đề đang để lớn lên.
So they begin to find a way in order to extract that sponge.
Và họ tìm cách ra là họ kéo ra cái cửa gòn nó ra.
And every day I have to feel pain.
Và mỗi ngày tôi cảm thấy đau đớn.
They have to shut the water, the fluid or the
medicine. Họ phải rút cái thuốc ra.
And then they have to suck it out.
Họ bơm vào, họ rút ra.
Do like that.
Bơm vào, rút ra. Bơm vào, rút ra.
And then when they cannot find out the location.
Họ không tìm thấy được cái.
You just imagine every time that the tube that they have to find in your body.
Tôi nhớ là khi một cái ống nhỏ đó họ cố tìm đưa vào trong cái
tiền.
Họ đã cứ lùn vào trong, họ lùn vào bên trong.
And sometimes. Now, but it become big like this, it will block.
Tôi nghĩ là một cái túi đó như vậy, những cái gò đó họ sẽ mở ra rồi nó lắp lại, rồi nó lớn khác hơn nữa.
How do you feel?
Cái vị cảm thấy như thế
nào? That was one of the worst.
Đó là một cái mà tệ hại nhất.
But that's how I understand the pain that Jesus.
Thì lúc đó tôi mới biết được, tôi mới cảm nhận được cái đau đớn mà Chúa đã trải qua.
And only then I begin to understand the pain of so many patients inside.
Và thế rồi tôi mới cảm nhận được cái đau đớn của bao nhiêu người bệnh nhân nằm trong.
Even China, Shanghai is very developed.
Ngay cả Thượng Hải thì những
người bệnh nhân nằm trong. But you know, because so many sick people, patients, so the facility was not enough.
Và những cái
many people have to sleep outside.
Và nhiều người họ phải ngủ bên ngoài.
And yet I'm inside with one room of my own, one bed.
Đó thì tôi ở trong phòng, một cái phòng riêng rồi tôi chính mình tôi.
It have not yet reached to VIP, but it's very expensive.
Chưa đến cái cửa một VIP nhưng mà cũng gần như vậy.
So I just thank God for that.
Tôi cảm ơn Chúa.
So what I'm asking you right now.
Tôi xin là xin quý vị gì đây?
Maybe no job is seen.
Có thể là chưa có.
And even today, our church is still facing, and I'm still facing.
Và ngay cả họ thấy những người không
việc no
làm, chính là tôi như vậy, không có việc làm.
But I'm still. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. You know it.
Và
and many people will begin to think this guy come here on January 18 until now he didn't go to work.
Nói cái cảnh này tính đến năm 2000 tháng Giêng 2018 mà đến giờ này vẫn chưa có việc.
Many sweat, yes.
Nhiều người đã đổ mồ
hôi. Many tear, yes. Many struggle, yes.
Nhiều người sự khó khăn có.
But drive good car, hallelujah. Rent in a good place, hallelujah.
Và đơn thuê bên đây rất là tốt.
Why?
Tại sao vậy?
I don't know.
Tôi không biết.
Let us answer next week.
Để trả lời câu hỏi trong tuần tới.
Many urgent payments.
Có những điều mà phải trả ngay tức khắc.
And it's not paying like $50 or $100.
Hay là $150 đâu.
Mr. Henry know. It's only about
2,000, 3,000, 4,000.
Thank God, we still have the God card.
Chúa nào Chúa cho chúng tôi một cái thẻ của Chúa.
The car have to sell because or else it's dangerous. The request have to move out. In this situation, the devil begin to attack you.
Và khi đó như vậy thì ma quỷ bắt đầu là tấn công vào trong tâm của chúng ta.
You are serving God.
Thấy không, người hầu việc Chúa.
You see, God calling you.
Thấy không, Chúa kêu gọi người.
You see, your God is powerful.
Thấy không, người Chúa kêu gọi người.
You see, your God is provider.
Thấy không, người nói là Chúa cung cấp cho người.
And I said yes, thank God for that.
Tôi có cái lời, vâng, cảm ơn Chúa.
I'm not going to let the devil begin to attack us.
Tôi không để cho ma quỷ nó đã.
And we will not give them a chance in order to win.
Và tôi không để cho họ có chúng có cơ hội.
That's why Psalm 61:69 while ago we said.
Giống như trong Thi Thiên 69.
When the water engulf us.
Khi mà Chúa đã nước đã tiêu ngục.
Just praise the Lord.
Chúng ta vẫn cần lời Chúa.
When the end.
Kết thù tấn công
chúng ta. Just give thanks to Him.
Chúng ta vẫn cần lời Chúa.
When the financial shortage.
Khi mà chúng ta thiếu tiền.
Just believe that God is provider.
Chúa là những người kế.
Situation here. First of all, people do not ask God. Secondly, they may ask God.
Họ có thể tìm cầu Chúa.
It's just for formality.
Chúng cái định nghi thức mà thôi.
They may just ask God, why don't you help me? Why don't you save me?
Chúa đã xong giúp cho tôi. Tại sao Chúa không làm được?
And they just run by their own strength and
ability. Sau đó là đi tìm cái ý riêng của mình, cái tâm sức của mình.
And yet there are people.
Những người có những
who are willing to go through the process.
Và những người có những người chấp nhận quanh
and they just like go being refined.
Giống như là đã được tu
so tôi today rồi. I don't tell you any hope. Today I'm just telling you that you have to go through the tough times.
Tôi nói quý vị thông qua những cái thời gian khó khăn
như Joshua had to be put into the pit.
Và chúng ta phải những vực sâu đấy.
He had to go to the house of Potiphar as slave.
Và trong kia Joshua cũng phải qua cái vực sâu đó và
he had to serve in the prisoner.
Phải ở trong tù này.
He had to see the betrayal.
Và thấy cái sự bị phản
bội. He had to feel the abandonment.
Và cảm thấy cái sự bị bỏ bê.
Before he became the prime minister.
Trước khi là trở nên người của Đức Chúa Trời.
So the most important thing is what or how is our behavior or attitude.
Cái điều quan trọng là cái thái độ của chúng ta đối như thế nào.
In those moments.
Trong cái hoàn cảnh đó, trong mình.
And you know that in that 2 months in the hospital.
Tôi hai năm hai tám tuổi trong bệnh viện.
Many times. I feel so pitiful for my wife.
Tôi cảm thấy là thương hại cho nhà tôi.
At that time, the two boys are too very small.
Và lúc đó hai đứa con nhỏ của tôi rất là nhỏ.
It's still very small. She had to work for. She had to provide the income.
Phải cung cấp công
evening, have to provide. I have to cook for what I like to eat.
Và phải nấu những thức ăn mà tôi thích.
And even though, because I would say no, I don't want to eat.
Mặc dù tôi nói là tôi không cần đâu em.
Many times I pretend to say I don't like.
Nhưng làm tôi nói cái giải đò.
But she know my character. I always say I don't like. But she just said you like.
Tôi nói là tôi không biết, tôi không muốn. Nhưng mà nhà tôi biết là tôi muốn như vậy.
You know, at that time you can look at my wife and I feel so pitiful.
Nhiều lúc tôi nhìn giờ tôi như cảm thấy là đáng
thương. And I was just wondering, the devil said, you cannot walk it well. You cannot live it well.
Mắc quỷ nói là không thể đi được đâu.
Every day I have a tail. You know, because of the
tooth.
Because of the tube, so they have a back. In order to get the to extract the
nut,
I have a tail to go behind, just like a monkey.
Tôi có một cái sau cái đuôi như con khủng khiếp.
See, when you look at that one, I don't know.
Quý vị nhìn thấy như vậy thì quý vị như thế nào? Tôi không biết quý vị.
All I tell you today is that you and I have to go through it.
Nhưng mà điều tôi muốn nói quý vị là quý vị có thể quay về
đó. God begin to teach. The value of the family.
Và cái điều tôi dạy dỗ cái giá trị của gia đình.
I don't have the time to tell you more, but the value of health.
Về cái giá trị của sức khỏe.
At that time, God begin to tell me how is.
Lúc đó thì tôi dạy dỗ tôi là cái đời sống của mình mong manh như thế nào.
And at that time, every day I go from one room to another room and people on the floor and share the gospel.
Và lúc đó tôi mới đi từ phòng chia sẻ về phúc âm.
And I see that people have the same situation like me.
Và nhiều người cũng có cái hoàn cảnh chúng tôi, những bệnh nhân giống với hoàn cảnh như tôi.
After the operation,
cũng giải phẫu.
Because it's also spread to all.
Vì cái ung thư đã lan truyền hết rồi.
The doctor stick it up.
Bác sĩ đã may lại.
Go home and prepare for your funeral.
Và đi về nhà để chuẩn bị cho quan tài của mình.
So in those days, I see so many vision and dream again.
Và khi lúc đó tôi cảm thấy là
I begin to reflect what are the things that I have done wrong in which I have never. I have never recognized it before.
Và khi mà lúc đó chúng ta có nhìn đó và điều mà tôi chưa bao giờ.
So when God begin to bring us through the tough time like this.
Và khi mà Chúa đem chúng ta trải qua những cái hoàn cảnh khó khăn như vậy.
Remember, He has a great purposes for you.
Thì Chúa có một cái mục đích rất là lớn lao cho chúng ta.
So instead of asking why God do let me like this.
Tại sao mà hỏi cái tình thay vì hỏi chúng ta tại sao Chúa để con như vậy?
It's nothing wrong to ask why.
Chúng ta không bị sai trái cả khi chúng ta hỏi Chúa.
But I ask a better question.
Và tôi hỏi một câu hỏi tốt hơn.
Would you in this situation?
Chúa ơi, tôi muốn con làm gì?
What are the lessons that you want me to learn?
Và cái bài dạy học nhiều.
What are the reflections that you want me to make?
Tôi muốn cho con phản tỉnh về.
And when you ask the right question,
khi mà chúng ta hỏi Chúa,
your life will never be the same.
Và đời sống chúng ta sẽ không giống nhau.
That many people worry about me, but actually I worry nothing.
Nhiều người cứ nhìn tôi và nói cho tôi, thật sự tôi không có lo gì cả.
Just because I'm maybe being trained through the tough time.
Tại vì yes, tôi đã được thêm sức qua những cái thời gian khó khăn rồi. Tôi
I still have other qua. Furnace, but I'll maybe go through the tougher furnace than this situation.
Và tôi đã qua những cái hồ lửa mà nó nóng nhưng mà tôi đã trải qua.
God only brought me through the time that I have to face the decision that go home or die.
Và những lúc mà Chúa đưa tới cái giai đoạn mà tôi phải quyết định là phải đi về hoặc là phải chết.
I remember that happened in Pakistan especially.
Nhất là tôi nhớ là cái trường lúc mà đi qua Pakistan.
In China, I don't need to say. This is listen to what the policeman said.
Và là Trung Quốc tôi nói là đừng nghe những gì.
The policeman talked to my wife that your husband is very smart.
Và người cảnh sát nói như nhà tôi.
But his problem is so he's so stubborn.
Và nhưng mà chồng cô đứng đầu quá.
We asked him to close church, he opened another one.
Tôi nói là ông là hãy đóng cửa đi.
Close on this side, he will open another one. But I remember in Pakistan at that time.
Thì tôi nhớ ông là ở Pakistan.
Three times.
Ba lần.
And especially on that day when we just reached to that place.
Khi mà tôi vừa đến nơi đó.
And when I look at the eyes of the leaders, I feel something wrong.
Tôi thấy nhìn mắt của những người mà lãnh đạo đó, tôi thấy cái điều gì nó không đúng, không ổn rồi.
And I asked them what happened.
Tôi hỏi họ cái điều gì.
And they said, okay, we tell you the truth.
Tôi nói ông sự thật.
2 hours later, the crusade will begin.
2 giờ sau đó sẽ bắt đầu.
But at that moment, the Muslim killed a Christian.
Và trước đó thì một người là giết, là Muslim giết một người.
Right there at the crusade field.
Ở ngay trong cái nơi mà.
What do they want to say?
Họ muốn nói điều gì?
Stop, or else all of you will be killed.
Họ muốn nói điều đó là hãy ngưng lại đi, nhưng mà tất cả mọi người, các ngươi sẽ bị giết.
And then they said, Pastor, what do you think?
Một sư ông nghĩ thế nào?
And then I asked them, so what do you think?
Tôi hỏi họ, ông nghĩ gì?
I passed the responsibility. You know,
trong lòng tôi đang chờ đợi.
You know what do I wait?
Tôi muốn gì tôi đợi.
I wait. He said, Pastor, it's dangerous. Why don't you just go to the hotel?
Tôi muốn nói là thưa mục sư, nguy hiểm quá, ông về nhà.
But to my surprise, they didn't answer like that.
Mấy là họ cũng trả lời như vậy.
They said, Pastor, we believe that God is going to protect us.
Và tôi nói mục sư, tôi tin rằng Chúa sẽ là người bảo vệ chúng ta.
And Pastor, why don't you just go back to the hotel and we will go on with the crusade?
Nói thôi, chưa đi về khách sạn thì chúng tôi sẽ tiếp tục cái.
And at that, I'm just crying out.
Và lúc đó thì lòng của tôi đã.
These people, they know that they are facing death, and yet they are still move on.
Người nói là những người họ đang đối diện với chết.
And here I come and let it declare in the name of Jesus, you will be saved in the name of Jesus.
Tôi đến đây tôi tuyên bố.
You will be set free in the name of Jesus. I can claim all of the famous sentences that I can make.
Thứ này kia nọ, nó tuyên bố đủ thứ hết.
But at that time, what are we going to do?
Thì lúc đó thì quý vị sẽ làm gì?
And I was moved by their brightness and courage.
Và tôi đã cảm động vì cái sự can đảm của họ.
Let us begin and trust God.
Và chúng tôi bắt đầu và tin tưởng.
And thank God, it was a very powerful and successful.
Và cái bữa họp đó rất là được quyền năng.
Three times.
Ba lần.
Not only one time.
Không phải một lần.
In three different places.
Ở ba nơi khác nhau.
So I leave the tough situation for you.
Tôi để lại cái hoàn cảnh khó khăn cho quý vị.
And I leave the right question for you to ask.
Và tôi để cho quý vị những câu hỏi.
When you begin to ask why,
it
will ever be the why and why.
Và quý vị sẽ lúc nào
and you will never have that answer for you.
Và không có câu trả lời cho quý vị.
So let us have the right attitude.
Chúng ta hãy có cái thái độ
in those situations.
Ở trong hoàn cảnh.
And of course, you have heard. God is always faithful.
Chúng ta biết là Chúa luôn luôn là trung thành.
Would you please stand up as we are going to receive the communion right now?
Xin tôi đứng lên để chúng ta có cái.
Let us have a time to respond. Let's have a time to respond to God's word today and begin to receive, to prepare our heart for the time of communion. So, maybe some of us are going through situation. Maybe some of us have asked the wrong question. Maybe some of us are also struggling very hard because of the situation. And I pray that the word of God today to let you know and I that God's servant also going through those tough situations. Jesus, the Lord Jesus, also going through those situations. You and I are no exception. But begin to prepare in those moments. There's some great and powerful thing will happen. And just begin to ask God, what's the lesson that you
want me to change?
What are the things that you want me to change?
Cái điều Chúa muốn chúng con thay đổi.
Or even what is the vision?
Hoặc là cái khải tượng.
Or the solution in my situation.
Hoặc là cái giải pháp cho đời sống của chúng con.
That you want me to take.
Hoặc là để chúng con có thể làm.
So let us, every one of us, just come to the Lord right now and just open our heart and begin to pray right now.
Xin mọi người chúng ta đến với Chúa như này và chúng ta cầu nguyện với Chúa.
And just respond to God.
Và đáp ứng lại với Chúa.
We know sometimes it's also very hard.
Chúng ta biết là
nhiều
lúc
chúng ta
rất là khó khăn.
But let us trust God once again.
Và chúng ta hỏi Chúa một lần.
Spirit, make me new. you for our God. Even that he was beaten, even he was persecuted, and even he was crucified on the cross, he is willing to do it until the end. May our life also begin to shine forth the strength that God is going to give us through the tough time, through the tough situation. And as we are going to receive the communion today, the Bible remind every one of us, every time that we receive the bread and the cup, we have to remember what the Lord Jesus Christ has done for us. And every time we receive the communion, it's also the time for us to re-examine ourselves. We have sinned against God and sinned against one another. If we have wrongdoing to God and other people, it's a time for us to reflect. It's a time to ask for God's forgiveness. It's a time of repentance right now. And we pray that the blood of Jesus will cleanse us from all of the curses and break all of sin away from our lives. Communion, not only the time to remember what the Lord has done for us, it's not only the time for us to re-examine, but it's also the time for us to continue to walk in the power of God and experience the power of God for healing, deliverance, blessing, providence, protection once again. Now on the day that and he took up the bread and he said, "This is my body, which have been broken because of you." And we thank God for this body of Jesus have been broken so that he can give us the new life.
Thank you, Jesus.
So that this body of us being restored, being redeemed, and being renewed every day. So let us live a life of worthy according to the call. And let us keep this temple of God pure and holy.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
And undefined by the things of this world.
Yes.
Father, we thank you for the body that has been broken because of us. And we thank you that, Father, you are willing to be crucified on the cross. And by that crucifixion, you have paid a ransom to redeem our deadly body, our sinful body. And today, become a temple of yours. And we thank you, Lord. Let us continue to remember there are still many bodies have been broken elsewhere in our society. That many bodies have been oppressed by the devil. Father, it's our task to bring the gospel to these people. And let them to experience the power of your resurrection and the power of your salvation. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Let's partake the bread together. After the bread, Jesus also took the cup and said, "This is my blood, and it's also a new covenant. And do this in remembrance of me. And this blood has been shed because of our sin. And it brings the restoration, bring the forgiveness of sin. And this blood of Jesus has been shed so that today we are healed in the name of Jesus. Today you and I are being sanctified and made whole in the name of Jesus. Whenever we receive the cup and the bread, let's begin to preach his death until the day he comes. Father, once again, we thank you for your blood. As we receive this cup, we receive your sanctification. We receive the righteousness that you have imputed to every one of us. We receive the forgiveness of sin. And Father, and we receive this cup once again. We pray that may you bring the freshness upon our life. May you revive and regenerate our body. May you renew our mind and give us the power in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that every circumstance that we are going through, we give all the glory to you. And we receive it with thanksgiving. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Let's receive the cup in remembrance of what the Lord Jesus has done for us. By Pastor Shurida, to make us come to respond in prayer for the Word of God and the communion today. Let's invite Pastor Shurida.
Thank you. What a mighty word. What a mighty word. I mean, it God is just an amazing God. He has done so many miracles in my life. I mean, just outstanding miracles. Only God could do. I was sharing with Pastor Joshua just a miracle of no finances, no, you know, home, and that I could even qualify for. And the thing was that I didn't ask God how. I never asked him how. I just said, okay. Every step of the way, I just said, okay. If the realtor would ask me for something, I say, okay. And that was it. It was never, ever, you know, like, okay, God, how are we going to do this? And I just want to encourage everyone that it doesn't matter what the realtor with the whomever says. It's like, okay, God, I will just walk in your path. I will believe. I will do what you do. Because you are God all by yourself. And I just know him to be true. He is true. I mean, he is so good. And he's so faithful. He's so faithful. I mean, if he says he'll do it, he'll do it. He's not a God that he will lie. He's not a God that he will lie. He keeps his promises. And he is faithful and true to his word. So whatever it is that you're believing for, just thank him.
Amen.
Father God, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for what you're doing.
Yes,
thank you for what you believe, that I'm believing you for. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father. I just thank you. I don't want to know why. Because you're God. And I just give you all praise, glory, and honor, because you are a God worthy to be praised. Yes. You are God all by yourself, and you are true to your word. You will never fail us. You will never, ever, never, ever defeat us. You are true, and I just thank you for being God. And we can trust you. And we believe your word.
Hallelujah.
You are our God. In the name of Jesus, let everyone leaving this place leave with these words. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I trust you. And I thank you with all my heart. No matter what it looks like, no matter what it seems like, you're God. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor.
I have a little. Thank you, yeah.
Wonderful, wonderful, Pastor Sharita. You share very powerful words from the testimony and very powerful words from the God's words. I would like to emphasize again, God is always faithful. Even though we are not faithful, we are unfaithful to God. I learned my own experience. Okay? I made a big mistake and God led me through. That's not in financial pit. So I never blame God because that's my mistake. God doesn't want us to be there. But our own choice. Okay, I remorse. Okay, I thank God. Recover whatever we lost.
Amen.
So I thank God for that, and I told God, I thank you. whatever we went through, I thank God because you teach me a lesson. Okay, because I don't listen to you. To go through that, but we decided to do that. So I apologize, God. I confess my sin, and I got really faithful. He recovered that. So don't leave straight away from God. Stick to Him. We sometimes we are weak, but God, we count on God. God will provide us one step at a time. Sometimes we run away. We run fast. God, okay, try to accomplish my project instead of your will.
Amen.
So God, okay, we thank you. So be faithful in our offering, faithful in what God has given to us, faithful in our words to God, because God has the abundance, has enormous, okay, the provision to us, the things that we count on Him, do we believe in Him, do we trust in Him.
Amen.
Amen. So it's time for offering, okay? We pass the sound, please.
Give thanks to the Lord, our God and King. His love endures forever. For He is good above all things. Forever.
Joshua, your voice is really coming along.